Welcome back to Napoleon Total War 3. Last time around we had three battles, one of which was auto-resolved at quite the negative effect of me, since I lost one of the sort of historical marshals. Why did I say so-called? It was historical marshal that we lost over in Hanover, which I thought was a given victory against the British Remain after the siege of Hanover. Which I find kind of strange. But anyways, and then we also took back Corsica from the Ottomans and destroyed their force. And then for the last part, we opened the way to Croatia by attacking the army that sacked the college or the academic building that we have outside of Vienna, and so opening up the way to Zagreb in Croatia, and hopefully we'll be able to take that at some point. But since we lost such a devastating battle against the British in that out-resolve, I find it that I found that I would go ahead and do this battle. So, without further ado, I think we'll go ahead and start it. They have a lot of cavalry that I'm going to have to be worried about, because a lot of the Belgian army, if you actually go close and take a look at it, quite a lot of those units, at least four of them, are militia units. And then the other ones, I'm not so sure about. And the enemy has a lot of heavy cavalry. So we'll see what we can do. But most likely, I'm going to take some form of defensive position and await the reinforcement of the second army. And yeah, we'll see how this goes. The British are, they have strong line infantry as well with them. They have some Scotsmen, some light, quite a few light troops and stuff. Looking at the terrain here, if I deploy the cannons over here, I'll have to move them up here, and given the cavalry coming on, that's not an option. Over here, we've got a hilly area that sort of covers them if they do not attack, which is going to reposition the artillery and such. And looking over here, looks like the best situation. So we're going to station our artillery piece right here. Then we're going to have the grenadiers and the 3rd Lightfoot of the 12th Regiment of Belgians right over here. Wait, was that... Oh, that's a guy from Empire. And here we got the Lightfoot. The reserve, I guess we'll put them towards the forest. Hopefully they'll be protected over here. They can form a pike square. Then we have the other two militia units. I guess we can form them over here. That will hopefully protect them against the enemy onslaught. Then we've got these three normal line. They will sort of swing out from over here. We've got the old guard, which will be stationed behind the cannons to protect them. And then we have the cavalry units that will be on this side. The heavy one will be behind there, and then we'll have the light one over here to hopefully fan out maybe towards the enemy. Did I look at all the special units? I think for most of the Belgians, these guys look exactly like the normal French units. It's the militia units that have the special uniforms. And, the Dragoons as well. They have a bit of different color scheme for the Belgian ones. And for these guys as well. The Chasseur Cheval. And then more of these militias over here. Of the Belgian variety. And, the Grenadiers. Quite fancy. And then the light troops, yes. The old guard we've seen. The general over here. And Let's start the battle. And we're gonna get reinforcements as well. Right off the bat, we're gonna have the Grand Battery open up fire on the enemy cavalry. So there's 10 cannons in that battery, which just tore straight through these horse guard. But these guys are very heavy cavalry, and it's going to be quite dangerous to face off against these guys. Let's see if we can face them off in line first, just to give a good volley. Before we... That did more or less nothing. Form square, form square! Ooh. Kinda lucky there that we were able to break them before. I guess we just need to go ahead and move our troops into position. These will fan out towards the forest. And then these two will march into the forest together with the Belgian Dragoons. The second general can be stationed over there. And he brings with him 3 horse-drawn batteries that will face over here. Possibly spread them out maybe a bit, depending on what I feel like. We probably can have one over here. Set one up there, and then the other two will be stationed here, just to so I have ease of access to and control over them. Okay, they're going for these guys. I thought you could form spike square. There we go. Form it. Form the square. Why can't you form your square? Well, then fan out in a line and help your comrades. Let's go in slow motion a bit to take a look at the squares being fought here. This one being a solid one, which is probably better against holding off cavalry, given the fact that the cavalry in this, with the submod I'm using, are actually able to break through the square. So the hollow squares are being able to be broken up, which is not too good. There we can see them; they actually countercharged. So I think this square has broken there, while this one will stay intact. However, we did send off the cavalry over there. And hopefully we can continue doing so. Anyways, I've moved one battery over there. The other two batteries we're moving over there. Possibly moving them closer to the forest, but I'm worried that they might get attacked. Let's go ahead and bring it back to normal speed. These two grenadier units will come and back up the Belgians. We've got the general and then some finer tuning on these two batteries coming up as we deploy them in between these trees. And they're horse-drawn, so we can have them run. This went quite badly. You can see that the grenadier unit has almost lost half its men and is forced to withdraw closer to the forest here. And it might be quite well that we get a artillery in between here to get this show on the road. Got an enemy unit. That sounds like cavalry charge coming on somewhere. Cavalry charge coming on towards the line of just line infantry, the Belgian line infantry. It's the 11th Light Hussars. They're charging forwards, and they're followed up by a general advance of the British line, which is not going to go too well for us. The Grenadiers will form a secondary line over here. And these two batteries, this one will form at a slight angle. And this one... Right, since the enemy is coming this close, we need canister. Did I get this one up as well? Get this one firing. Get this one in position. We got the Dragoons. They need to move out to the side here and see if they can strike the enemy cavalry. Not very good though to fight in the forest. On a slight angle there, they will now go ahead and deploy and fire canister, and then we'll see about redrawing these two squares. Move them into line like so. So we're able to meet the British volley fires as they come down here. We've got Highlanders being submitted to quite devastating canisters. There's a lot. Let's just go ahead and slow-mo here because I was want to take a closer look at what the British have brought. So, more dragoons. The lights are now breaking through the square, and the square is possibly about to break completely. We got Scottish line infantry here, followed up by another Scots foot guard, and more Scottish troops coming up. Boom! Canister flying through here. And we just heard the square there break up. The enemy is coming on here, but we got a lot of cannons trained on this position. So canister will be flying. This unit has been broken. Let's see if we can rally it. This one is about to go as well. We need the cavalry to come in and save here. Save this unit. And pull back to normal speed. Get the grenadiers up there. We need to protect here. Get the grenadiers up there as well. General, I need you behind there. So much canister flying here, really saving us on this side. So many British troops in the forest right now. Especially cavalry. Do I have any more men I can push into there? We've got the guard unit, which I guess we can move over. We've got a bit of a melee clash going on here. We got the Highlanders charging, and then they decided not to charge and just run in front of the line. The cannon crews firing their canister. This one is in quite bad shape because it's right in front of these guys, and they're continuously just boom, letting canister after canister go straight into them. There is quite a melee going on here right now here, and the Scotsmen are a lot stronger than I think, or than the Belgians are. Belgium's not doing too well. The reserve group's not doing so well either. We got the old guard coming in. They're going to plug the gap. And the grenadiers are helping out there. And we've got the general just behind. I think we need to mobilize this side. But this one's really too small. And these two are vulnerable to cavalry attack, so I guess this one is the only one we can send out.
Our men are running, sir.
To start dealing some damage over there. The Scots are breaking through, but once the old guard starts firing upon them, I think we can change that. I really would like the ground battery if they could start pulling round shot. Ooh, look at that. That's nasty. That's nasty. The grenadiers there are getting flanked fire by the Highlanders. We got this unit of grenadiers charging out of their formation to deal a blow to cavalry. It's actually cavalry out there. Units are breaking. Did I send out the cavalry? Yes, it's out there now. It will now swing around. The canister is now being focused towards this area. There's so much enemy cavalry moving around. We need to just form squares to protect ourselves. Get the general inside the square. This general needs to come closer here. This Belgian unit is running for its life. Oh no, it's not a Belgian unit actually, it's a grenadier unit. Why are you running that way? No one told you to. Switch over to round shot and see if we can target something in there. What have you snagged onto? The general, the enemy general. The squares are holding. So that's good. Now we're getting round shot flying into the forest. The Belgian dragoons have put up a good fight throughout here, together with this square. We got some Highlander Lightfoots. But it looks like the British are giving way here. Or quite a few units are.
Sir, our general is under attack.
Get the light cavalry up there and deal a blow to those snipers, which are sniping the general. They've sniped quite a few of his bodyguard. But here comes the light cavalry to sweep them off their feet. They are in need of aid. Hit those Lightfoots in the back before the Belgian dragoons give way. Are you able to... Yeah, these guys are still able to fire at something. You are still firing round shot. These two will also start to fire round shot. Let's see if we can win the forest. Yes! The Highlander Lightfoot are giving way, and it really saved the Belgian dragoons, but realizing that the fight was over there, they did not no longer need to hold the forest, they gave way, and we can retreat the reserve unit out of the forest. I don't think the squares are needed anymore. So we've got these two guard infantry units.
Victory,
they will march up towards the enemy. We've got this normal line unit, but he sort of move. If he moves too far, he'll move into the firing range of the enemy. So we'll make line just next to them. And the cavalry will line up on this side. The general will follow. Or maybe I should use this general because we can lose him. He's not like a historical face general. Cannon shot flying through the Lightfoot. The 10th Lightfoot is making an attempt to protect the British army as it retreats. We got a militia unit moving through the forest. Let's have the light cavalry move in and sweep them away. As the Grenadier Guards are advancing on the village, the enemy gives way. And we can now see the British troops running from the battle. We've got Lightfoot, the Dragoon, the Horse Guard. Oh, there were Dragoons as well. And there we have it. We have a victory. An heroic victory, and I'm going to just mark this down as such. And we have an heroic victory against the enemy force. We lost 1,000 men, but we took out their entire force because there's nowhere to run from the village. The Imperial Battery took out 800 men. Next to that was the Chasseur à Cheval, which came in at 300. The 16th Belgian. The 45th Belgian did well as well. Then we have... Well, there's a lot of batteries up here. Where did the Dragoons? They did... Even though they lost 100 men... And they killed 150 57, so not like a major impact in that sense, but the fact that they were able to hold all that cavalry and all their units on my left enabled me to not get absolutely swarmed on that side. The British, if their forest would have fallen, they could have pushed out there and flanked my big battery and dealt a lot of damage. Worse, I want to see where the reserves. Here we got reserves. They did not too bad, these two. But these were the ones that weren't really put on the front line. The other two that were put on the front line did quite a lot worse. Or at least this one that was actually broken and sent away. But we did pretty good, I'd say. And I'm not going to give them autonomy just because the British invaded. But clearly, we need to improve our defense in case the British come. The Belgians gained some good experience, I hope. But quite a few of these units that are present will be sent to the front with Napoleon at the best given moment, especially artillery, which is lacking up at the front, and also the old guard units, but we'll match the Belgians here with some French units to bring it up to more of a better speed, as it were. We can have some... we could have quite a lot of these, so we could have two of these, maybe. Because I have a total of four being able to recruit it. Or maybe just more of the normal kind. 37 in morale. How much different is that to the Belgians? There's not really a difference in between them and the Belgians, but I guess the pressure they were put under, given the fact there was only really four normal units. I should actually look at these guys. Well, the Belgians actually have higher morale. It might have been the fact that they were in a battle now. But the fact that I only had three, and the pressure that they were put under, compared with the fact that they were backed up by these crappy reserves. And I'm building some stuff. I'm building the Arc de Triomphe. We've gone 10 turns on that. And I'm also building the Musée of Napoleon, which apparently enables some units. Dragoon, the Imperial Dragoon, may it be the Empress Dragoons, Trillier of the Young Guard, and Grenadier of some other guard unit. Actually, the ones I'm recruiting right now. Let's see. I wonder if I have time to do the Battle of Zagreb as well. And then next one could be the big battle at Budapest. If I feel that these armies should be ready to push forward, this would be a hell of a battle. And since I have some crashes lately, I need to make sure just that it doesn't crash, because doing such a large battle would obviously require quite a bit of time and preparation. And it's quite annoying and sort of messes with the style of commentary when you go ahead and do that. So I'm just going to quickly close down and see how far we've gotten the recording. I don't think there's enough for another full battle, which this would be. So we'll see. We will see. Well, given the time that we have left, we do not really have enough for another battle, so this will be a little bit shorter than 30 minutes, but maybe I can match this by releasing some other video, Sniper Elite or something. We'll see how that be, or how that will go. Anyways, I hope you enjoy this battle, and I hope I see you guys for the next one. Bye.